If you're looking for a fun, energetic, surface-dwelling fish that won't get too big, you gotta try the Furcata or forktail blue-eyed rainbowfish. Hi, my name is Irene with Aquarium Co-op, and when I was setting up my first community tank, I had already planned it out. I wanted fish, Corydoras catfish on the bottom layer, some neon tetras in the middle, but I was looking for something kind of colorful and maybe a little more uncommon for that top layer. So I went to my local fish store and I was immediately drawn to the furcatus. They had these bright yellow fin tips, really, really amazing, almost glowing blue eye. And then the males, they have these, their pectoral fins are clear with these yellow tips on them. So when they swim, it looks like they're waving around yellow pom-poms. It was so cool, I had to get them. Now, when you go to the fish store, make sure you get a group of at least six or more, because honestly, they like to shoal together. The more, the merrier the party. In fact, oftentimes the store will only sell them to you in pairs of male and females together because the males are prettier or more colorful. I oftentimes like to get one male for every two females because the more females you have, the more the males seem to really color up. They love to show off to the girls, and I love it when the males do their sparring behavior where they start circling each other. It's really cool to see. They get about 2 inches, 5 centimeters long, so I would recommend a 10-gallon aquarium or more just because even though they're on the smaller side, they do like to swim around a lot and they're pretty fast. They originally come from Papua New Guinea, so in slow to moderate flow streams with clear water and lots of vegetation. So I'm sure they would appreciate a heavily planted tank to explore around in. As with most surface dwelling fish, make sure you have that aquarium lid up top so that they won't jump out. In terms of water parameters, not really picky. I would say temperatures from 75 to 80 degrees Fahrenheit. And then like most rainbow fish, they do like more alkaline pH, so above 7.0, but again, not a big deal if it's slightly below. And then GH, I would say probably 5 degrees or 90 ppm of GH or more. So if you have really soft water like me, you might wanna add some more mineral content using Wondershell or Seachem Equilibrium. As for tank mates, they're really easygoing. So I would say any kind of peaceful community fish that's similarly sized that won't eat them. So anything like Corydoras, Tetras, Rasboras, I kept them with a mono shrimp, so I'm sure they would be fine with at least adult dwarf shrimp, but they might snack on some babies. And then I also kept them with my crown tail betta fish named Darth Vader. He didn't seem to mind that they were kind of occupying that upper one-third space that he likes. He's pretty chill about it, so might be worth a shot. The only thing I would maybe recommend or caution against would be slower fish. Because they are so fast, it'd be easy for them to outcompete any slower fish during meal times. Speaking of food, they are also not picky when it comes to meal time. They'll eat pretty much about anything you put in the tank, as long as it's smaller, because they are small fish with small mouths. So things like Daphnia, Cyclops, frozen or live baby brine shrimp, crushed up flakes, even our easy fry food, all of that they'll be more than happy to go after. Now I wanna be real with you and just let you know, as much as I like furcata rainbowfish, there are a few downsides to keeping them. For example, they are a bit pricier, just like other rainbowfish, compared to your average neon tetra or guppy. And then the second con is they don't live very long. I had no idea when I got my first furcata rainbowfish, but they only live about 2 to 3 years. However, thankfully, they're pretty easy to breed. So as long as you have, you know, one of each sex, and then when you go to your local fish store, I would kind of make sure you get some of the younger, smaller juveniles, just so that they're young enough to still breed. To condition them, feed them lots of good fresh foods, and then you might want to keep the temperature slightly on the higher side, around the 80 degrees Fahrenheit range, and then provide spawning mops or floating plants with really long roots like dwarf water lettuce so they can lay their eggs in them. Males can mate with multiple females per day, so that's another reason to get more girls. And then the females will lay a few eggs every single day in the spawning mops, which are rather large compared to the size of the adult. So you can easily spot them, pick them out, and then put them in a separate container or a breeding basket to hatch. Depending on the temperature of the water, it could take anywhere from 2 to 3 weeks. And then I personally haven't done this, but some people like to add a few drops of methylene blue to prevent the eggs from developing fungus. Once the fry have hatched, you can feed anything like, oh, infusoria, live vinegar eels, powdered fry food, as well as live baby brine shrimp, the best, especially if you want to grow them up fast and big and strong. Good luck with your furcatas, and I hope you get as much enjoyment out of them as I did. Take time to enjoy nature daily, and I'll see you later.